Hi folks, this is Ben from CarryPad.com. I've got the Nexus S here and I wanted to give you a little overview of the device. So this is Google's second Nexus phone. The first one was made in partnership with HTC, and this one is made in partnership with Samsung. So this is a lot like Samsung's Nexus S devices. It's got a very similar feel to the case, but it does have a couple of things that differentiate it from that line. The first of which is that it's running Android 2.3. It's one of the very first devices to do so. And it also has a built-in near-field communication chip, which I believe it's one of, or the first phone in the U.S. to have that. So let me power up the device here for you real quick. And while that is happening, let me take you around the outside. So on the right side here, we have nothing except for the lock and power button. Let me focus on that for you. Hopefully that's good. On the top, there's just a notch to pull off the battery cover. The whole back comes off, just like the Galaxy S devices. On the side here is a volume rocker and nothing else. And on the bottom, we have a micro USB charging and connector port. Here's a mic and a 3.5mm headphone jack right there. And on the back, we've got 5-megapixel camera with a single LED flash. A little vent right here with probably some speakers under it for the speakerphone. And while we're at it, let's check inside to see if we have access to the micro SD card. Not a big fan of the way that the backs come off of these devices. It always feels like you're going to break it. Alright, so inside we've got the SIM. And I don't believe there's any access to the built-in memory, so don't plan on upgrading that. Let's get the back on here, and the phone is now booted up. Get the fingerprints off of it real quick. And here it is. This is a 4-inch screen. It's 800 by 480 Super AMOLED, and the quality of it is just outstanding. The colors are beautiful. Contrast is excellent, the best I've seen on any phone that I've ever used. And it's got Android 2.3 on it, which has a couple little things that we will show you. So to begin with, I want to look at Google Maps here, which has received a nice 2.3 update, and that is the fact that they're using vector graphics now to draw tiles, which is very handy because it leads to less data usage because it doesn't need to download as many tiles, and a couple other advantages which I'll show you right here. So what vector tiles really mean is each tile has all the information necessary to draw that tile at several different zoom levels. So if you watch right here, as I zoom in, the roads are actually being changed in real time rather than having me zoom in and then have to download a brand new tile. And actually, if you look at the text right here, I'll try to get a little bit closer. As I spin the map, that actually stays right side up, and road names flip over to stay right side up. That's something you can't do with static photos. So that's pretty sweet. Vector graphics also allow us to change the angle that we're looking at here. So you can get sort of a 45 degree angle, and in areas that support it, you can see buildings that are drawn in 3D and stuff like that. Now on to a couple more 2.3 things. Let me pull up a text box for you real quick. This is something that has been severely lacking. I can't believe it's taken them this long to do it. But we finally got a good way to position the cursor. So here's a random text, and I can actually grab this here. Oops. Grab this little thing that'll pop up to move the cursor around, which is just so useful. And it's also good for selecting text. Say, select word, and then it'll give me two, and I can adjust them as I need to. And now that it's highlighted, I can, you know, delete a whole phrase at once, which is nice. And another 2.3 improvement. You're probably used to the battery information center in 2.2, and they've updated it. I've got a graph up here. So in addition to seeing the different stuff that's consuming the battery, you can click on this graph, and a neat way to visualize the data shows your phone signal, how often the GPS has been kicking on, which is great in case latitude is coming on more frequently than you want it to, how often Wi-Fi has been on, how often it's been awake, the screen, how often it's been charging. So lots of awesome uptime information, and you've got a graph up here that is presumably your charge level, and good way to analyze your power usage and make sure that you're getting the best out of your battery life. Now before I sign off here, I want to show you this really cool lock animation that they built into Android 2.3. I'll hit the button real quick, let you watch it. It's so quick and so simple, but it's really impressive. I'll try to get it in close. It's probably going to be hard to see without your own eye, but as this field collapses, you can actually see the different colors from the image separate. Have a look up in this area here. You may be able to see the reds and the blues come out of those different colors, and it's a really convincing tube TV style turn-off effect, and it's smooth every single time I've ever done it. So it must be integrated at a very low level so that nothing can really impact its performance when it turns off. It's just a neat little visual treat that's fun to watch. So that's the Nexus S, and we'll be talking more about this device on CarryPad, so come on over and check it out. Get ready for the full review, and we'll have gallery and all that great stuff posted. So thanks for tuning in, guys. This has been Ben from CarryPad.com. Have a great day.